साइंस टीचर हु इज द वंडरफुल एंड अमेजिंग लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म ऑन द अर्थ हुम डू यू थिंक इन माय ओपिनियन प्लांट्स आर द वंडरफुल ग्रेट लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स ऑन द अर्थ बिकॉज they are growing not only for themselves they are growing for other living organisms also completely every living organism directly or indirectly depending upon the plants for food and oxygen that is why plants are great and amazing living organisms in this lesson we are going to learn about the plants how they are growing and how they are reproduce in this lesson we are going to learn about growing plants we are learning growing plants this is our first lesson in the market there are many vegetables so if you see there are many vegetables colorful vegetables are we are seeing in the market okay like potato beetroot carrot capsicum and leaf vegetables also so this is a cabbage children which part of this plant we are used to eat so in previous classes you learned our plant the parts of the plants are leaves stems root flowers fruits these are the parts of the plant so in this cabbage plant which part we are used to eat which part leaves very good in the cabbage we are used to eat leaves okay if you see beetroot and carrot these two so which part we are used to eat in this plant in this carrot plant and beetroot plant so we are used to eat the root of the carrot and the root of the beetroot okay at the same time if you see the green leafy vegetables and the green leafy vegetables we are used to eat the leaves not the stem not the root in the green leaf vegetables we are used to eat the leaves only okay and see here is a potato okay just think and tell me the answer which part of the part we are used to eat in this potato okay generally people thought that potato is a root no potato is not a root potato is a stem the potato stem store the food inside the soil that means it is not a root so those are stems not a roots like this different vegetables are we are getting different vegetables from the plants the plant grow how does a plant grow generally everyone know that a plant grows from a seed but not all the plants growing from the seed some plants are growing from their stem leaf root and bulbs also let us see how a new plant is growing generally a new plant is growing from a seed or stem root and leaves so these are the parts we giving a new plant let us see one by one
growing plant from seed a seed grows into a new plant by the process of germination my dear students to understand the germination process we will do one activity observe carefully
come children let us observe how a baby plant comes from the seed if you observe some fruits like apple orange lemon mango you will find a hard part inside the fruit what we call a hard part that hard part we call seed yes these are seeds inside the fruits seeds are present and these seeds are growing as a baby plant maximum we knew that seeds are has embryo inside see here I have badam seed children do you observe any baby plant inside the seed no it is not visible to us now it is inside when will it comes out if you sow the seed in the soil then only it comes out so when we sow the seed in the soil then only it comes by the process of germination so in the seed there is a baby plant but it won't comes out now by the process of germination the seed germinated and gives a baby plant before going to see the germination process we'll see how the structure of the seed helps to grow as a plant. See children, here I have some seeds, Bengal gram, flax seeds, groundnut, green grams and badam. If you observe the structure of the seed, a seed contains in layer. See, are you able to observe this? See your children, here is a light layer. This layer is called seed coat. The seed covered with a layer, and this layer is called seed coat. What is the function of the seed coat? This seed coat protect the baby plant and protect the inside the parts. So this seed coat is protect the baby plant. And if you remove the seed coat, observe two equally half parts. Two equal half parts. See very carefully how to remove this, because inside there is an embryo, no? That's why. See, I remove the seed coat and open the seed. There is a two half parts. These two called cotyledons. What we call these two parts? Cotyledons. And there is another part. If you observe in the middle of the seed, see, this is a baby plant. What is this? This is a baby plant. We call it is embryo. The baby plant, we call the baby plant embryo. And this embryo grows as a new plant. And what is the function of these cotyledons? These cotyledons provide food for the future plant. These cotyledons store the food, and these food is helps to the seed after germination. So this is the function of cotyledons. Right, there is a baby plant called embryo. Here it is, the embryo. And when we sow the seed in the soil, we observe that a small part comes out. A small delicate part comes out, no? See, this is a small delicate part. We call it is radical. First, whatever comes out, it is called radical. These radical goes down into the soil and grow as a root system. Later, these cotyledons are come up and gives another part called plumule. And these plumule grow as a shoot system. See children, I'll show you how the plumule comes out. If you see, if you observe, I open these cotyledons. Wow, here are you seeing? Do you observe this? See children? Wow, nice. They are looking like leaves, no? Yes, this is radical, and this plumule, it comes out and grow as a shoot system. Good, very nice. Okay, and this is the germination process. This is the complete structure of the germinating seed. When the plumule comes out, if the leaves are started, then these cotyledons are dry up and fall down. Okay, this is the seed germination. Very good. Once I explain you what is germination. Germination is a process that a baby plant comes out from the seed. This is germination. Children, let me know, what are the factors does the seed need to grow? Need air, water, warmth to germinate as a seedling. If we sow the seed in the soil, from the soil it takes water and air, and the soil produce warmth to the seed. And in these conditions, the seed germinated within few days. Some seeds are taking 1 day or 2 days. Some seeds are taking more than 3 days.
Children, today we learn the life of a plant begins from a tiny seed. A seed contains seed coat, cotyledon, and an embryo. This embryo gives a new plant. And when the water, air, and moisture gets sufficiently, then the seed germinates. Children, in the next class, we will see how does the seed disperse and growing plants from the vegetative parts. Thank you, children.